We deployed 119 camera stations across the largest protected area complex in West Africa. It's a transboundary national park that spans Burkina Faso, Niger, and Benin. We were really interested in understanding how both people and wildlife coexist in places, and national parks are one of the primary conservation strategies that we use worldwide. We know that people are using these protected areas and animals are using those protected areas. Not all human activity is created equally. Some things are really bad, some things not so much. We need to know what people are actually doing in those places. One of the primary uses that we documented on the cameras were people moving cattle through the national parks. So buffalo are very similar to cattle. And so you can imagine that there could be some competition if you have lots of cattle coming through to graze and drink water, etc. With hundreds of thousands of images that we're getting out of these surveys requires a small army. And so there's undergraduates in the lab as well as graduate students that were involved in the identification and the sorting of those images. You know, a picture's worth a thousand words. Seeing an image does stimulate additional curiosity.
Seeing just the extent of the human utilization of the park was surprising, and so many different types of activities too. So we saw livestock and herdsmen, we saw people gathering materials, and then there are also poachers.
Designing a project that is relevant for the place that you're working, that is culturally sensitive, that is transparent, and that is inclusive requires a different strategy. I have an amazing field team that was set up. It includes students from some of the local universities, the government staff and government rangers. I have an armed guard with me the entire time. It's a very laborious process, to say the least, but it's a really amazing opportunity and a privilege where we can co-create or co-design the work together so that ultimately do work that has impact to manage and preserve the wildlife that are there.